we are going to integrate x times tangent square x. As we can see, we have x multiplying with a trig function and the input for the tangent square x. This is just x to the first power, so we know that the u substitution wouldn't work. And it's not a good idea to write this in terms of sine and cosine because we have this x on the outside. Let's try to do this with integration by parts. Because we know we can integrate tangent square x. In the meantime, of course, we can differentiate x. Let me use the integration by part with the DI setup. Because for integration by part, we are going to pick something to be differentiated, and then we are going to pick something to be integrated. And then on the side, let's put down the plus minus to get ready. Don't forget the sign on the side. I'm going to integrate the tangent square x. Let me put that down right here. This is doable. In the meantime, I will choose x to be differentiated. If you have seen my other video, to integrate tangent square x, the way to do it is, I will have to look at this as secant square x minus 1. And this is actually much easier, right? Because we know the integral of secant square x, this is just tangent x, and then the integral of minus 1 is just minus x, right? And then let me differentiate the x one time. The derivative of x is just 1. That's pretty good. As we can see, we have x and then we get 1. If I differentiate this one more time, I get 0. And then you see that we have 0 in the d column. We know we have to reach this row. In fact, I don't need to have the last row right here. I just put down a plus minus earlier to get ready. Well, I need to go ahead and integrate this guy again, right? Can we do it? Yes, we can, because the integral of tangent x, this is something that we have to remember. The integral of tangent x is ln absolute value secant x, okay? And then minus the integral of x is just 1/2 x to the second power. And so you see, these are the ingredients, and I can write down the answer for you guys. Once again, we stop right here because this is the first kind of stop. We have the 0 in the d column. Okay, here is the answer. The product of the diagonals are the answers. First one, we have x times that. So I will put down x, open the parentheses, because this we have two things. Tangent x minus x, like that. And then we will have minus 1 times this. So make sure you have this sign right here as well. Minus 1, so I put down the minus 1. Multiplying with all that, which is the ln absolute value secant x, and then minus 1/2 x squared, like this. And we're pretty much done with the integration part. Now we can just do some algebra to simplify the expression a little bit more. For example, I can distribute the x into the parentheses right here, and then we are looking at this as x tangent x, and x times negative x, that's negative x squared. Also, we can distribute the negative 1 into the parentheses like this. So we have negative ln absolute value secant x, negative times negative becomes plus 1/2 x to the second power. The only thing we can combine is the negative x squared and then the positive 1/2 x squared. So here, let me just write down the answer down here. This is the x times tangent x. Let me write down this part first. This is minus ln absolute value secant x, and then negative x squared plus 1/2 x squared. We are doing negative 1 plus 1/2. So we have minus 1/2, and that's the x squared term. So that's pretty much it. So we can put down plus c right here, because this is it. You can totally just stop right here.